Caffeine, a legal stimulant that most of us are pretty familiar with, many of us use every day, and some of us are addicted to. If you're a caffeine user, you probably know your limits. For me, one small cup of coffee in the morning can help keep me alert and focused, whereas two small cups of coffee in the morning can turn me into a cat on catnip. Well, for the purposes of this video and to best demonstrate the physical and mental effects of caffeine, I'm going to get very, very caffeinated very, very fast. For science.
Go big or go home.
Caffeine is a stimulant drug that acts on your central nervous system. Because caffeine is both lipid and water soluble, it can easily pass through the blood-brain barrier and act on the interior of your brain. Once there, caffeine works by diminishing the effects of a neurotransmitter called adenosine. Adenosine acts as a suppressor for your nervous system, reducing neural activity and slowing everything down. Caffeine and adenosine have similar shapes, so caffeine can bind to the same neural receptors that adenosine does. But because caffeine is not adenosine, it doesn't turn these neural receptors on. This is called competitive inhibition. Caffeine competes with adenosine to bind to the same receptors. And because caffeine is bound, adenosine cannot bind and its effects are inhibited. Long story short, caffeine prevents adenosine from slowing down your nervous system. So this explains part of why you feel more awake, alert, and active with caffeine flowing through your veins. But adenosine inhibition isn't the only thing that caffeine does. Oh no. Caffeine also stimulates the production of adrenaline or epinephrine. Adrenaline is a pretty well-known hormone involved in the fight or flight response. It causes all sorts of physiological reactions. It increases your heart rate, increases the blood flow to your muscles, opens up your airways, causes your blood pressure to rise, and also causes your liver to release extra sugar into your bloodstream for an added boost of energy. It also causes your muscles to tighten up, which would be useful if you were the lone human on the savannah deciding whether or not to fight or flee from that lion off in the distance, but as a modern 20-something sitting in front of my camera, it just kind of gives me the jitters. Finally, caffeine also plays with the dopamine levels in your brain. Awesome! Yeah! Caffeine increases the amount of dopamine present in your brain by slowing down its reabsorption, much in the same way that cocaine increases the amount of dopamine present by slowing down how quickly it can be sucked back into your brain tissue. This means that caffeine also makes you feel good, and this interaction with dopamine is how you can actually build a caffeine addiction. So now, you're a happy, jittery, fight-or-flight-ready bundle of caffeine. Now what?
Well, the now what really depends on how your specific body metabolizes caffeine.
The average half-life of caffeine in the human body is about 6 hours, so this means that if you have 200 milligrams of caffeine in your average cup of coffee at 9 a.m. in the morning, then 6 hours later, half of that will be left. So at 3 p.m., you will have 100 milligrams of caffeine left, and then another 6 hours later, you'll have half of that 100, so you'll have 50 milligrams of caffeine left at 9 o'clock at night. But dude, who stops at just one cup of coffee? Not this chick. So how much caffeine is too much caffeine? A lethal dose of caffeine is about 200 milligrams per kilogram. So it would take about 9,500 milligrams of caffeine to kill me. And there's about 200 milligrams of caffeine in a standard cup of coffee. So that's about 48 cups of coffee, which is a surprisingly low number. But I would have to drink all 48 of those before my body started to metabolize the caffeine, which means I would literally have to chug 48 cups of coffee. I literally wouldn't be able to drink that much coffee, both because my stomach couldn't hold that volume of liquid and also because, as every coffee drinker knows, caffeine is a diuretic. Before I got to cup 48 anyways, the stimulant effects of caffeine would be jacked up so high that the alertness and awakeness would be transformed into mania, disorientation, and hallucinations. Great. What would eventually kill you would be ventricular fibrillation, which basically means that your heart would caffeine jitter itself to death. So moral of the story is that caffeine is a drug. It is a stimulant that has some pretty noticeable effects on your body, can cause addiction, and, in high enough doses, can kill you. So caffeinate wisely. Go forth, do science. It's actually not shaking too bad right now. Don't try this at home. I know a lot of people do drink that much caffeine all in one day, and sometimes I approach it, but I certainly don't do it over the span of 20 minutes. I actually don't feel as terrible as I thought I would after that amount, but I certainly don't feel good either.